The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 19, verses 25 to 27. Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple there whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Mary at the foot of the cross is a beautiful image and picture of she being the mother of mercy. A woman, a mother, had to see her beloved child dying on the cross. The child whom she had born in her womb, the child whom she had carried in her arms, the child whom she had seen growing up, going about, doing only good for people. This mother had to see her beloved little child dying on the cross. Yet, even in that heartbreaking moment, our Blessed Mother is the beautiful image and picture of being the Mother of Mercy. A beautiful story, an incident, is told about a criminal who was in jail, sentenced to death for the many heinous crimes that he had committed. This man, a Christian, had lost track of Christian teachings and had gone on to commit many crimes. A priest who had heard about this criminal wanted to meet him towards the end of his days. The priest expected to talk to this criminal and bring about a conversion in his heart. As the priest approached this criminal, the man refused to talk to the priest. The man would not budge in to all the concerns that this priest had for him. Finally, the priest would ask that man, the criminal, "Would you do just one simple favor for me?" Wanting the priest to just go away from his presence, the man would agree and say, "Ask me, what should I do for you?" And the priest told this man, "Can we hold our hands together and can we together recite the Hail Mary?" And so saying, the priest began reciting the prayer Hail Mary. "Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you." The priest had not completed that first sentence by when the man already had some tears welling up his eyes. The priest continued with the prayer. At the end of that beautiful prayer, the priest saw this criminal, this man, kneeling at his feet, asking for pardon and mercy, and pleading to the priest to make a confession so that he could receive the mercy of God. The beautiful prayer, Hail Mary, especially the words, "The Lord is with you," had touched this man's heart, and his heart was moved in contrition and repentance to the mercy of God. Yes, my brothers and sisters, everyone who turns towards the Lord in contrition and repentance will receive the mercy of God. That is why it is so beautifully said, the ocean of God's mercy is greater than all our sins and our failures. And this priest would invoke the intercession of our Blessed Mother, the refuge of sinners, the Mother of Mercy, to bring about repentance in this man. Yes, Mary is the refuge of sinners. Mary is the hope of the hopeless. Mary is indeed the Mother of Mercy. The letter of Saint Paul to the Romans, chapter 3, verse 23 says, everyone has sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Everyone is in need of the mercy of God. And Mother Mary was specially chosen by God to be freed from sin, immaculately conceived, and thus she would receive the mercy of God right at the moment of her conception. There was this incident in the life of Saint Maria Faustina, the great ambassador of the divine mercy. A confessor would once go to her and ask her to pray for his intentions. Maria Faustina would say a novena of 9 Hail Holy Queens. At the end of that novena, she would have a vision of Jesus and Mother Mary. And in that vision, Mother Mary tells to Saint Maria Faustina, child, I am not just the Queen of heaven and earth, I am also the Mother of Mercy. As it was also told to Saint Bridget of Sweden, she is not only the Queen of heaven and earth, she is the Mother of Mercy. It is to this Mother of Mercy that all of us are today invited to put forward all our prayers, our petitions, to consecrate our lives to her heart so that she can intercede before the great throne of God's mercy and obtain favor, blessing, and mercy for us. What do we learn from Mary, the Mother of Mercy? First of all, we understand that because Mary was immaculately conceived, she is the most important and the greatest recipient of God's mercy. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verse 28, we read, when Angel Gabriel came to the young virgin girl of Nazareth, Mary, he would address her as, Hail Mary, full of grace. Being full of grace, being freed from sin at a very moment of conception, Mary becomes the greatest recipient of God's mercy. What is mercy? A free gift given by God. It is not something that is merited. It is not something that God gives to us because I do something, but it is purely a free gift given by God. And Mary received this pure, unmerited gift from God. And being the immaculately conceived person, she is the greatest recipient of the mercy of God. And the one who has received more knows to love more and knows to teach others how to love God more. Do we need to have more and more of God's mercy in our life? Then let's run to our Blessed Mother, the Mother who herself received the mercy of God in her life. The second dimension that we can reflect on is that Mary can be rightly called as the Mother of Mercy because she gave birth to Jesus, the merciful Savior. We know the meaning of the name Jesus. coming from the Hebrew word Yehoshua, Jesus, means God saves. Yes, Jesus is the fulfillment of the promise of God to humanity to save humankind. And Mary, by giving birth to this merciful Savior, becomes the mother of mercy. In the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verse 14, we read, "The Word became flesh." By accepting the will of God in her life, Mary would give birth to Jesus into this world, and thus she becomes the mother of the merciful Savior. As Pope St. John Paul II, in his encyclical Veritatis Splendor, would say, Mary is the mother of mercy because through her, Jesus Christ would be born into the world, the face of God's mercy. Each of us are invited, therefore, to adopt and go more and more towards Mary, our mother, and seek refuge in her, especially in our moments of struggles, difficulties, and disappointments. The third aspect that Mary, the mother of mercy, teaches us is the beautiful virtue of humility. Humility is indeed one of the greatest virtues that all of us who seek to follow the Lord ought to have in our life. Jesus said, "He who wishes to follow me must deny themselves, take up their cross, and follow me." This following of Christ requires, demands all of us to have humility in life. And Mary is the perfect picture and model of someone who humbled him. And Mary and picture of someone who would humble herself before the great grace of God. And Mary is the beautiful picture of someone who would humble herself before the great grace of God and thus allow the Lord to be given birth in her life. At every moment of her life, we see self before the grace and the will of God. After having consented to the will of God to give birth to the sonful act of Mary going out in humility, the visit to her cousin Elizabeth. With all her difficulties and struggles, Mary makes a tedious journey to reach out to her cousin Elizabeth. And she takes care of her cousin Elizabeth in all humility. She does not pride herself in the fact that she is now going to be the mother of her Savior. Rather, more the graces given to her, the greater she would humble herself. Is this not something that we also see in the nature itself? The greater, the taller the tree grows, the deeper its roots ought to go. Mary would become great in the eyes of God because she was willing to lower herself in humility. Today, we live in a world which flaunts itself in pride and fame. We look forward to a world with its values. We run behind the world very often, which promotes things that only seek for pride and things which cause fame and name. It is in this context Mother Mary comes to us as the beautiful example of humility and invites and challenges all of us to take up humility as a daily virtue we practice in our life. My sisters and brothers, my people of God, the Lord is inviting all of us to look deeper into our lives and to check areas wherein I still need to humble before God. Look into your lives and see, so many are the graces that God has given you in your life. Nobody on the face of this earth can say, I have not received a blessing from the Lord. Very often we close our eyes. Very often we remain indifferent to the miracles happening every day, every moment in our life. Mother Mary today invites with love and compassion, invites all of us to look into the great graces God showers in our life, and thus to lower ourselves in humility and follow the path of the Lord in our lives. As the Gospel of Saint Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 very beautifully says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything else will be given to you. Can I today check the priorities of my life? Do I seek God and his kingdom? Do I seek the will of God in my life as the highest and the greatest priority of my life? Yes, God invites all of us to jump into his ocean of mercy. And for this, Mama Mary is the greatest intercessor for us. She today invites all of us to run to her, be in her embrace, and learn from her. Just as she, who was willing to lower herself in humility, just as she, who was willing to say yes to God at every moment in her life, Mama Mary today invites all of us, teaches all of us, her little children, to listen to the word and will of God every moment of our life. Mary, the Mother of Mercy, is here with us always. She wants us to experience the mercy of God. As I said at the beginning of the talk, the ocean of God's mercy is greater than all our sins, our faults and failures. We may have committed a lot of mistakes. Perhaps at this point, some of us are feeling, can God really shape up my broken life? To all of you then who are broken, who feel shattered, who feel hopeless about life, who feel, can God work a miracle in my life? I invite you, seek the refuge of Mary, Mother of Mercy. And she will intercede and pray for all of us to receive the great grace and mercy of the Lord. Let us make the examination of conscience a daily habit in our families, in our personal life, every day checking whether I am living in the grace and the will of God. Every day by examination of conscience, checking if I am following the commandments of God. And realizing and recognizing, perhaps I have turned away from the ways of God. Let us make a metanoia, a turning around to the will of God. And for this, we have our Blessed Mother to intercede, to pray for all of us. Let us always take refuge in Mama Mary, the Mother of Mercy, and experience the joy of the Lord of living according to his will in our lives. May God bless all of us. May Mother Mary, the Mother of Mercy, intercede and pray for us. Live Jesus.